It was finally during the Rath Yatra preparations in San Francisco that he found the location of the ISKCON center. He came to the temple where His Grace Jayananda Prabhu was making the Ratha cart for Jagannatha. His Holiness Jayaprakash Swami Maharaj was drawn into service of the Ratha by Jayananda Prabhu. Later he met Srila Prabhupada, who encouraged him by inviting him to take prasadam with him and making sure he got more than just general servings. In just 2 months after visiting ISKCON, His Holiness Jayaprakash Swami Maharaj decided to commit himself to the principles of ISKCON. And the first most important service for the land in Mayapur, His Holiness Jayaprakash Swami Maharaj went there on the instruction of Srila Prabhupada. And local farmers were surprised. Maharaj taught modern techniques of agriculture to the farmers, and they taught in Bengali. He began to give classes in Bengali, where his few listeners would correct him in his language, and soon he began to perfect his knowledge of the language. Jayaprakash Swami Maharaj had wanted to learn even in 1968 when he was in the West, but it did not seem necessary there. His desire was fulfilled automatically when Srila Prabhupada sent him to Bengal. Eventually, they got a three-room warehouse built at the main gate of the Mata. Maharaj made it a point to preach not only in the cities but also in the interiors of India, in the villages. And Prabhupada once told him, "I have given you the kingdom of God, now develop it," with reference to Srila Mayapur. Ramhatta. In Los Angeles in 1970, before Jagtak Maharaj had come to India, Prabhupada had stopped in front of a church and said that in the future there would just be a few devotees in the temples, but so many would be practicing in their homes. At that time, it was hard for Jagtak Maharaj to understand this, as most devotees were living in the temple and there was no congregation. And he also has a boat called Nithai Pada Kamla boat, which goes around preaching down the river Ganges in Mayapur. And Food for Life for constants, and he's renovating them, and he's also uniting the Saraswat family.
His father and uncle were Zamindars. They had to pay annual tax to the government, but the uncle had no issue, he was the heir to everything. He was the only son. Only son. So like this. But he was not interested. He was a grahastha, but he wanted to leave everything. He ran away from home and joined Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. The Lord Chaitanya sent him back. Said that grihasthas should stay with their home. They should leave. They should practice from their home. Let their mind in heart be with Krishna, but that they should do their duties materially very nicely. So other than the husband, she may do her housework more nicely than the other women. And she don't want to be discovered. Like that, you can keep your heart with Krishna, but you do your material affairs very responsibly, so everyone will be satisfied. This is the standard for the grihasthas. For 1 year, Raghunath Das, he was doing his grihastha work very nicely. In that time, there was a former tax collector who had been displaced by his agenda and he got back. So one day, Raghunath Das got an idea. And he went to see Lord Nityananda at Panihani. So then when he went to Panihani, Nityananda was seated on a rock platform, stone platform, under the base of a large banyan tree. Many devotees stood around him. Some were on the ground and some of the respectable devotees were up on the stone platform with him. To see Nityananda's forcibly caught him, placed his lotus foot on his head. Nityananda Prabhu is very merciful and very funny. So being merciful to the Raghunath Das, he spoke as follows. Nikotena, I want more workers to further villages to buy more pots. He bought hundreds and hundreds of round pots. They started to mix and soak the chura. You know, chura you have to soak in water for 10-15 minutes, wash it off. And some you mix with hot milk, a dense milk, some with the chura, with the heat. He mixed with some special kind of banana, you know, in Bengal called chini chapa. These are very sweet, small yellow. One scientist told me at the Banana Research Center in Hubli that these are the bananas with the highest percentage of sugar in the world. But they also have the highest percentage of vitamin C. So if they're not ripe, they taste sour. They have to be fully ripe and then the sweet and comes out. So such kind of our sin is taking their two parts and taking their prasad. Nityananda called Lord Chaitanya by mantra and he visibly came and was with that festival. Taking from Krishna, some was giving to Krishna's mouth. Children were playing in this way. Sometimes some cowherd boy had simple meal. Some have, like Lord Krishna had very opulent kachoris, so he would share with the others. He would take from the others and eat. Like this they were having. So Nityananda in the mood, he had accepted all these people as his cowherd boyfriends. So he was taking from their part and putting in Krishna Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's mouth. Papa, no mobile phones for me. No gossip. Only the sound of Haribo!
Haribo!
Hare Krishna!
Hare Krishna!
Krishna Krishna! So you are so fortunate he can directly get me through this. After this festival, then they had a lot of kirtan and dancing at the house of Raghunath Raghunath Pandit. In the evening, they had a prasad, regular prasad. Then in the night, the next day, Raghunath Das, he pleaded before Nityananda that he wanted to join Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, but he was not able to do so. So Lord Nityananda said, don't worry, you'll get the blessing. Very soon you'll be able to directly try to approach Krishna, bypassing the bona fide guru who's present. And that's very offensive. You won't get to Krishna that way. In spite of even talking to Lord Chaitanya, he was sent back. So you need to approach the Lord through the Guru Parampara, not directly. Even when we are serving the Lord, we serve as a servant of the servant of the servant of the Lord. We serve as servant of our Guru. Krishna. So that life leads also to serve Krishna through his representative spiritual master. Sometimes someone out of pride, out of ignorance, this is not very pleasing to Krishna. Krishna is more pleased when one serves a devotee of the Lord and one tries to serve Krishna directly. Serving Krishna is facilitated by serving his bona fide spiritual master, who is a Vaishnava. Guru should never say that he is God. He should never say everyone is God. Guru should teach that everyone is servant of God, and that everyone should serve the Lord. Although that Guru is a servant of the Lord, he is considered as an external manifestation of the Lord. The Lord is teaching his devotees through the example of the spiritual master. And people are not able to make proper progress. Krishna also told Arjuna in Adi Purana, those devotees who say, they are my devotees, they are not my new devotees. Those who say that the devotees are my devotees, they are my devotees. The servant of the servant. Even when the disciples would come to Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur and offer their obeisances, join at it, they were the body. Mind, we are trying to enjoy the senses. But in spiritual life, we know we are the spirit soul, which is a part of Krishna. And they try to use our mind and senses in service of Krishna. This way, we are freed from all kinds of karmas. And even while we are in this world, we are all considered as a great soul. Iha yasya hare dasi karmada manasa gira Nikola Swapka Vasta Suru Jiva Mukta Sapachana. Some delayed reaction. They used to preach all this in the different villages around Navadvip. There's a song that explains this.
Namaste. Which is that? This is a pure.
No, is that?
Which is that pure method?
This one, I hope it is.
Is this with water?
No.
Yeah.
Very water. So wash your hand, bro. Put it down. Wash your hand.
Shina Shingha, Jaina Shingha, Jai 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 Shina Shingha. From there to some great laws. So like that you can say, I'm sorry, I lied to you, I can't give it. Because the Guru was afraid if my disciple gives the three steps that this Vamana Dev is wishing, then what will he have? Something like that. But Bali Maharaj, he said, all along you told me I should worship Vishnu. By worshipping Vishnu, I could achieve this empire of the three worlds. So now Vishnu is asking me for three steps, I should give it. I already promised to give it. Who faced even after chanting Hare Krishna? So Bali Maharaj, he was worshipping Vishnu, but he faced this test. Vishnu is asking, give me three steps of land. And his guru is saying, don't give what Vishnu wants. He'll take everything. Then he decided that guru is supposed to represent Krishna. If guru is not representing Krishna, then I should follow Krishna. Generally, the guru is always advising us according to Krishna's instruction. That's his duty. If our guru tells us to don't follow Krishna, then even we have to reject the guru. But so long as guru is telling us how to serve Krishna, then it's offensive to reject the guru. Then we have to follow. So in the Shastra, very few cases you find where guru is giving such instruction. I can't think of any other. But so like this, Bali Maharaj agreed to give the three steps of land. But as you know, the history in two steps, Vamanadeva, one step he covered the whole world, and the other step he covered the whole three worlds. He made his body so big it covered the whole universe. So then he asked Bali, you've already taken all of Bali's kingdom. Where do I put the last step? So where did Bali say to put the last step?
On my head.
On his head. Pardon? What's Christ happy? He lost everything. But after losing everything, Krishna gave him back. And he told Bali Maharaj that after I forget how many, so many Manvantaras, you'll become the legitimate Indra. He'll actually be the Indra. Then he'll be Lord of the three worlds. He won't have to fight for it or steal it. He'll be the authorized Indra. But I don't think that time has come yet. It's still a few, some Manvantaras from now. We also heard that once in a year he can come back to the three worlds and see all his former praja. And so in the Kerala, that's observed as Onam festival. And Bali Maharaj is glorified by all the Vaishnava Shastra. It says, Vaishnava Dharma, you practice the nine practices of devotional service. You know the nine practices? Sravanam, Ketanam, Smaranam, Bandhanam, Parasevanam, Archanam, Dasyam, Satyam, Atmanivedanam. So which one did Bali Maharaj perform?
Atmanivedanam.
Atmanivedanam. He surrendered everything. So he's an example of someone who surrendered everything to Krishna. So always we are remembering how to surrender to the Lord. But by remembering that wonderful example of Hari Maharaj. Actually, the land of Kerala and the Western Ghats of some portion of Karnataka is known as Parsuram Chetra. It says that Parsuram gave away, conquered all the Kshatriyas, gave so much away to the, back to the Kshatriyas again. He had no kingdom, he had no land himself. So then he asked the ocean for some land back. So the ocean said, as far as you can throw your chopper, you can have that much land. So he threw so far. So that area of land which came out from the mountains to the coast, supposed to be the reclaimed land, gotten for Parsuram. And that's a very holy place. All along that area there are many temples. In the Tiruvananthapuram, there's the famous temple of Padmanabhaji. And in that Padmanabha temple, actually Lord Chaitanya visited that temple. We've also placed one lotus footprint of Lord Chaitanya, and the devotees are preaching there also. Padmanabha, who's in the lying position, Ananta Padmanabha, lying in Ananta Deva, as well as Lord Krishna, there in this ancient temple, which is under the sevaitship of the former kings of Travancore. Also, nearby there's the temple of Janardan, which is one of the Divya Deshas mentioned by Ramanuja, and another holy temple on the bank of the ocean. Near Trichur, there's the sacred temple of Guru Vayur. There the Krishna Deity is worshipped very elaborately with the elephant processions. And in the worship there from the very morning, Krishna starts off, the priest, when he was young. So I also got from Guru Ayappan. In the morning, he's just a child, so he wears a kopin, a little red kopin. So that when that his uncle was head priest, he gave me one prasadam kopin that I keep always in my briefcase, wherever I go. I didn't tell anybody. Maybe that's why I can travel. My Guru Vayur, the Vayu is also in the Guru Vayu. All the blessings are there with Krishna. Like that, of course, even further up, it's out of Kerala, but then of course, Udupi is also in that Purushuddha, Parsuram Chetra. That whole area is a very sacred place. When you read the tourist books, they advertise. In fact, I heard United Nations said that Kerala was a paradise on earth. In India, it's one of the most beautiful places, filled with coconut trees, filled with very luscious, lots of rain, very beautiful. Now there's a drought going in different parts of India, but in Kerala it's always sufficient rain by the Lord's mercy. So Bali Maharaj, if he's coming to see his praja. You know, Bali Maharaj is the great devotee. And he'll be the most happy if he sees that his citizens are devotees also. That we're chanting Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Previously there was such relationship between king and praja that it was like father and son, father and daughter. It was a very close relationship. The king really felt for his subjects and was trying to take care of them. So Bali Maharaj was such a personality. He never had anything else because he had enough punya to be in that position. Only because of the tapasya of his mother, Aditi. Vamanadev came and gave this special blessing to Bali. Sometimes they'll be struggling. You read in a newspaper, they're having divorce, they're having disease, they're having so many problems. But theoretically, they have big houses, big cars, opulence. So it seems that they got ahead of the system. So in the demon crazy system, the democracy, everyone tries to get up to that position. Of course, George Harrison, he said, we thought that when you're rich and famous, that was the goal of life. But when I became rich and famous, I realized that I was still not happy. I was still not satisfied. There was something more that was missing. So that's how he came looking for a guru and he got Srila Prabhupada. Now, if a person is wealthy, famous, opulent, but they actually remain attached to Krishna and they don't get intoxicated by their material success, then it's considered to be the best blessing. This was confirmed by Lord Krishna, by Lord Vishnu. When Bali was tied by the Vasuki rope, his wife, I think his wife's name is Vrindavali, it was your special mercy on him. So now he can realize that everything is yours. But the Lord said, it's not my special mercy, that's ordinary mercy. Blessing of Krishna, he's the proprietor. Then Krishna says, I don't have to take it away from you. It's only when people get the opulence and they think, now I don't need God anymore. Now I got in the world. And at the end, feel good about it. He felt very good. Rather, he felt only bad. I watered that tree with the water of Sravanadi Jal. The nine practices of devotional service, starting from hearing and chanting. Then in this way, everything becomes auspicious. So how many of you are chanting Hare Krishna regularly? Hare Bol!
Hare Bol!
If you're not, please do. Seems more or less everybody is doing. We're very happy that the Onam festival is being celebrated. Actually, in one of Bhaktivinoda Thakur's bhajans, where he says, I said it this morning in my class, Krishna bolave jabe pulaka have jorabe aki bolite. What's the next one? Hare Hare. So we should chant Ona. The Hare Krishna Mahamantra. So now it's Ona, just remember about the Naam also. The Ona. The Hare Krishna Mahamantra name. By chanting the holy name, Onam Gai, Then you'll get the full blessings of Krishna. In Kali Yuga, life is very short. I was walking yesterday in the city center plaza, and there was a sign in one shop. It says, "Life is short, enjoy it to the fullest." really enjoying. Because they're only thinking that they're in the material body. So they're trying to only enjoy the material sense, and they're simultaneously, then materially we're also experiencing what is the material life. At least the grihasthas are. Sannyasis, whom we have renounced. But the option is to experience what is material life. But we know that's not the ultimate thing. So we don't want to waste too much time with that. We're experiencing that, but simultaneously we want to really experience what is a spiritual happiness.
Today, we are in Mathura Desh for special programs with the devotees who are preparing for a feast. We are in one farm. There will be initiation. His Holiness Devataka Swami Guru Maharaj will give initiation after a few hours. Now we have a special program after the Vyasa Puja of His Holiness Jayapataka Swami Guru Maharaj in Mayapur. The devotees here would like also to offer their homages for the Vyasa Puja again of His Holiness Jayapataka Swami Guru Maharaj. And things are getting prepared. After that, there will be a special lecture, and then we will have the initiation ceremony.
You, so many places and nobody going to eat. So that you see, gap.
तो गुरु महाराज ने कहा कि आप चिंता मत कीजिए
तो वैसे भी नहीं
खत्म हो जाए अपने देखने को नजर आए
तो हैविंग योर एसोसिएशन सो वैल्यूएबल
नाउ आल्सो अनदर थिंग व्हाट ड्यूरिंग द पास्ट 1 ईयर आई थिंक वर्किंग ऑन द डेटाबेस ऑफ द योगीज ऑल ओवर मथुरा देश अबाउट 70% थ्रू बट अनदर 30% इज लेफ्ट ओवर So I wish to complete it by this.
নাম প্রেমের বন্যা জগতের প্লাবন করে দিয়েছেন, এমনকি মেলোচ্ছ যমুনা পর্যন্ত আপনার শ্রী পাদ মধ্যে আশ্রয় নিয়েছে। আপনার দয়াতে আজ সারা পৃথিবীতে নামের বহল বয়ে চলছে। পৃথিবীতে সমস্ত দেশ, বাংলাদেশ, ভারত, রাশিয়া আদি সর্বত্র শ্রী প্রভুপাদের গঠিত ইসকনের জয় জয়কার হচ্ছে। আর আপনি নিজে গুণে কৃপা করে এই দেশেও দেশে নাম রেখেছেন, এই দেশেও অকাতরে কৃষ্ণ প্রেম দান করছেন, যেখানে আজ থেকে নব্বই বৎসর পূর্বে মন্দিরের দূরে মন্দির দূরের কথা কেউ হরিনাম পর্যন্ত করার আশাও করতে পারে নাই, এমনকি হিন্দু পরিচয় পর্যন্ত আত্মগোপন রাখতে হতো। আজ সেই মরুভূমিতেও আপনার অভূতপূর্ব কৃপার প্রভাবে এবং আমার শিক্ষাগুরু শ্রী বিজয় বিনোবা প্রভু এবং শ্রী প্রেমাপদ্মী মাতাজির পরিচালনায় আপনার যে ভক্তি বিশ্বাস নাম হটার সঙ্গ শিল্পগ্রাম দিয়ে সেই শিল্পগ্রামের মাধ্যমে এই মথুরা দেশেও অন্যান্য দেশের মতো প্রতি স্থান কৃষ্ণ চৈতন্য মহাপ্রভুর বিলাস। আর অনেক মানুষ কৃষ্ণ মুখে হইতে উঠিয়া কৃষ্ণমুখে হইয়া আছে।
Whatever menial service I am awarded by the Lord, I should go into the best possible way to please you in your service. Your inspiration and instruction for every one of us to preach and sell to your Lord is really very nice to preach, which is the only thing which gives worthy happiness to the heart. By preaching, I am not trying to follow what I am preaching to others. This way, I am also growing, apart from helping and serving others to grow. Thank you, Kriyamu Mugay, for the mercy you are sharing your goodness. I beg to you for all the offenses that have committed to your divine grace for this feast. I beg to you to keep me under the shelter of your lotus feet forever and ever. And my service to you today, I am not. By the mercy of Venugopal Prabhu, Mataji and
Prabhu,
I have been awarded the service of taking care of his self.
These
are all our self-members. And then on this auspicious day, four of them have committed to take your shelter from today. And four of them have committed to take Prabhupada's ashraya.
And
the members drove all the way to me. I'm collecting your Srimad Bhagavatam class for Mataji in the morning and Bhagavad
Gita study in the evening for all the members,
which
Mataji is conducting in the Bhakti Shastri class, but I'm teaching the same. Very powerful. And then, we fell down under the teach. We had Baba Maranatha recently, being brought up in a non-Vaishnavi kind of family, so that he can teach his children. Mataji, Prabhupada Bhakti Mataji took us for his special darshan. Then he came to ask us, he brought with us.
Why you want to write? You have to be BP and see, you have come to service road or not? You have come to service road? Okay, but
the iron man is very poor. That is why
we share the devotees and the to please more and more disciples. Yes, for one, I am the right hand of India. Thank you.
श्रवणं मुकुन्दा पदारविन्दं हृदयेषु येषाम् पदारविन्दं हृदयेषु येषाम् Translation by His Divine Grace, Sri Srimad A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada. These are Om Tat Sat. Here it explains we need to hear the glories of the Lord from the spiritual master who is a pure devotee of the Lord, as well as from the pure devotees. But not only should we hear about Krishna, but we should hear about the devotees of Krishna. So in your Vyasa Puja offerings, you are glorifying this humble servant and remembering the words of the Shastra. Vyasa Puja means to worship the Guru as the representative of the entire disciplic succession. So here you have observed this by representing the Guru, by respecting the Guru as a representative of the disciplic succession, and the whole disciplic succession is worship. The Guru is always himself in a mood of a humble devotee of the Lord Chaitanya. At the same time, the Guru is considered by Shastra as an external manifestation of the Lord. Just like the post office box. The post office box is not the entire post office, but it's connected to the post office. And if you put your letter in the box, it should go to its destination. Like that, a bona fide Guru, by serving him, or by remembering him, or by hearing from him, you're also getting connected to Krishna. It's important, essential for our spiritual progress. A spiritual master, Prabhupada explained, should be a liberated soul. And there are two kinds of liberated souls. There's a liberated soul like Narada Muni, already has his Sachidananda body, who is fully transcendental. Then there is also a liberated spiritual master who is liberated by serving his spiritual master. And serving a liberated spiritual master. So I'm not claiming to be liberated like Narada Muni. But sincerely trying to serve his divine grace in the A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, who certainly is a liberating spiritual master. By serving him, will also be liberated. But this is the system. Guru Parampara, to be the servant of the servant of the servant of Krishna. Lord Chaitanya, when he was asked his identity,
चेतने बात
उन्होंने
बताया उनको वास्तव में उनकी पहचान पूछी गई तो उन्होंने बोला कि
शूद्र
भी नहीं हूँ
उनके
दास का दास जो नंद महाराज के
In this way, by interacting with the spiritual master, we get all our doubts eradicated. When we become free from doubts, free from offenses, then we become a ripened pure
devotee.
This ripening process may take a very less time or may take more time. Depending on how sincerely we try to practice our Krishna consciousness. Just like somebody may take 4 months to take Bhagavan Ashray,
or somebody may take
4 years.
It's
up to the individual. So, the process of ripening is going on. Eventually, one becomes fully satisfied. When we can satisfy Krishna, then we will also become fully satisfied. Let's end here. That Krishna was so pleased with Vidura that he put his lotus feet on the lap of Vidura because Vidura was very meek and gentle. Vidura, of course, he's much older than Krishna. How many of you would like to have Krishna as Lord as feet on your lap? Give massage to Krishna as Lord as feet. You can't imagine how much mercy. Because Vidura was serving very humbly. Sometimes Shri Duryodhana had invited Krishna to come and eat at my house to give you a Raj Emperor feast. Sorry, Already I was invited by Yoda and I had to go to Krishna wasn't caring to eat in the emperor house.
He's
already Lord of Lords. But he wanted to eat his devotees of him. So when he was
taking
the offering in Yoda's house, afterwards he would sit and relax. Then he put his feet on Yoda's lap and Yoda would give him a massage. At that time Yoda's hair and his body would stand up and his tears would swell in his eyes. So he was very happy at that service, at Maitreya. He was happy that they ate the glories of Krishna. But in raining the glories of Krishna, his hands were also standing on him. So these topics about Krishna are fully nectar. The glories, they exchange their realizations about Krishna and about Krishna's
devotees.
Pure devotees. And this way, they get purified.
और इस तरीके से वो अपने आप को शुद्ध बनाते रहते हैं हमेशा एक दूसरे के साथ प्रश्न करते रहते हैं
हमने the material world there are so many discussions and we read the newspapers
and we don't know anything about Krishna's
glories usually talking about politicians talking about sports people talking about musicians
politics के बारे में
But here the Lord is, they like to talk about Krishna. And Krishna's devotees. Because this they are really truly
worshipable.
Krishna likes to talk about his devotees.
When
Haridas Thakur left the world, Lord Chaitanya was facing him. How he was beaten in 22 marketplaces, but he tolerated the pain of the
biggest
How he was chanting 300,000
names of Krishna.
Thank you for watching our videos. Be sure to subscribe to our channel. We publish new videos every day, and don't forget to like and share our channel.